supported by and do not reflect those of the Evening Rush Network. Viewer's discretion is advised.
You are now tuned into Sex, Love, and Alcohol, hosted by Chrissy and Dutch, where we talk about, educate, and debate everything there is to know and learn about sex, love, and alcohol. So if you can relate, let's debate. Be sure to follow and subscribe to the Evening Rush Network on YouTube and tune in with us each and every Friday at 9 p.m. to Sex, Love, and Alcohol, powered by the Evening Rush Network.
Hey, what's up, what's up, what's up, yo? This is your girl, Chrissy. And of course, we got my boy, Dutch, in the building for another episode of Sex, Love, and Alcohol.
We here. We back. Another week.
Another week. Aren't we on a roll, baby?
I would say so. Like, I would say so. But how was your week?
Nah. But before we get into that, though, you know, we always got guests in the building. No, we got some spicy people in here today, boy. We're going to have to prolong this intro for a second. Let people tune the fuck in. Hold on.
Yo,
we got my homegirl, Whitney, in the building. Whitney, say what up.
Hey, y'all.
And we got my boy, Chills, in the building. Say what up.
Shaking, what's good.
Seriously?
That's what the man says.
Whatever.
So, Miss Whitney, what you got going on with yourself, love?
Nothing. I'm chilling. Y'all can catch me on Instagram at my name is Whitney Felice. And I'm just chilling. I'm just working. Being a mom.
Whitney Felice?
Whitney Felice, yep.
The whole government's on.
I got some businesses too, but they on hiatus, so we're not going to go there right now.
Well, hush us?
Yeah.
Oh. Should we be doing this government watching though? Judges watching? Oh shit. Hold on. We're gonna keep going low. On to the next. Chills.
Kidding, my guy.
You tell me.
What's your different toilet papers? On to the next.
What's going on with you?
You tell me?
Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. I don't know what you guys going on.
Instagram handle is, I got two. I got Charmin Fitness, and I got Best Flicks with Chill. I'm trying to get the photography taken. I'm an amateur photographer coming up, so if you want some shots, I hear a shooter. Got you.
Charmin Fitness, you a personal trainer or some shit or something like that?
I like working out.
Okay.
He's
that's
one
why
of
he's
them.
So buff. He's Buff Daddy right there.
Buff Daddy, though?
Yo, she called him Buff Daddy, yo. Yo, she's starting off already.
No.
She called him Buff Daddy. Come on, Sheik Looseless, and then she said his hoodie was too tight.
Yeah.
So keep it up.
Here we go.
Oh, she needs something to grab onto, sir.
Y'all dragging.
She needs something to grab onto, sir.
I'm just saying, listen.
2 + 2 = 4, and it's like, hey.
I can't. Good fucking bye. All right. So today's show, thank you guys for really tuning in with us. Each and every Friday, like, yo, we are, you know, getting kind of out there. And I appreciate you guys. And I hope you guys actually enjoy the show, the topics and the guests, the different guests that I have on the show every week. And, you know, stay tuned. And, you know, next week we got another hot show for you. But
this week,
I don't know. It seems like all y'all are some nasty motherfuckers out there
I'm an angel. I just want to put that out there.
First of all.
I'm an angel. I have a halo over my head.
First of all, because this show, when I made this flyer, I never got so much reposts, and you know what I mean? It was the support
was
for
crazy.
Me.
It was crazy.
It was the support
it
for me. All y'all
just
real motherfucking nasty.
Y'all just nasty.
Okay.
Just nasty, nasty, nasty. And y'all all need to go to church on Sunday or
Seriously?
Something. Y'all just
Seriously?
Nasty.
Seriously?
Okay, but on to the topic. Let's go.
So,
let's talk about
today's
it.
Show is
Oral.
Orgasm.
Threesomes.
And we also got
other topics.
First date or wait? As in, are you smashing, taking that down on the first date?
Are you giving?
Or
a
you
want to
give
limit?
It some time? You know
like
what I mean?
3 months?
Y'all got some. Of y'all got that time
it.
Limit. That little, you know, let me wait 3 dates or 3 months. So how about I'm celibate for this nigga? But
21.
Yeah, you wasn't celibate for the next one. So I don't know how y'all mix this shit up yet. Some of y'all just different, but you know.
Let's go to the perfect. Let's reel it in.
We're gonna go backwards today. We're gonna go backwards because the other one might go over time.
Yeah,
so we're gonna go backwards today. So, to my guests, Are you guys a first date or wait person?
It depends on the vibe. If we vibing, it is what it is. We've grown. But if, you know, I usually give it 3 dates. 3 dates is usually my, you know, standard.
Can I ask, when you say 3 dates, do you mean 3 times seeing each other or 3 actual dates? No,
we can see each other
dates?
A couple times, but 3 actual dates when you take any out.
Okay. Interesting.
But if not, it can happen on the first date. It depends on the vibe. But that's like the standard, 3 dates.
All right, Charles, what you got to say, bro?
It's a vibe, definitely. But it depends on the time spent. I feel like it's the time spent conversing. Like, say, for instance, I'm talking to Shorty, say, 3-4 months. We're just chopping it up. And then we link for the first time. It's happening for 3 or 4 months. It's the first date. It don't feel like the first date because we've been so, you know what I'm saying? So
texting and all that.
If I want to take it down on the first date, seeing her, it's nothing crazy because I've been talking for 3-4 months. I've been marinating that, you know what I'm saying? Like,
that's a fact. That's a fact.
I got a little scenario. And for all y'all watching, and listen, y'all can tune in. If y'all can relate to the first date or wait topic, y'all tune in. It's 929-441-2417.
Yes.
The number again is 929-441-2417. So call in if you can relate. But listen, sometimes the one date takedown or that, not even the one date, like sometimes you might peep shorty or dude and be like, yo,
yeah,
I'm taking that shit down today. Like, I don't even know you, son, but that shit coming down today.
Now, is that
like,
considered a one night stand?
Like, It might not be a one night stand.
It might turn into something else. It might progress into something else, but
it can be
left as a one night stand in that situation.
Like, have y'all ever? I'm just gonna throw it out there. Like, say like events, a party, or some kind of function. You go out with your peoples, your home, like, you know, your girls, your guys, or whatever, and y'all be like, nah, I'm sure you bad, son.
Yeah. Okay. Especially on vacation. Like, fuck it. Nobody know me here. If you on my list, you on my list. Niggas going down. So
First of all, chills over there sipping, and not
chills a little too chill right now.
I'm cooler right now. I'm doing the game right now. I'm just like,
nah, cause I ain't gonna lie, it, no shame in my game. Someday it has happened. Like you know, sometimes you meet people in a club, whatever, or a party, or you even go out to a family function. Well, not your family function, but somebody's family
cousin.
Cousin. Not your family function, but somebody's family function. Be like, yo, yeah, cousin look all right, son. Y'all end up talking, vibing, you know, end up sliding off somewhere. Like, shit happened. Shit happened. It's not even a date. Shit just happened.
That's happened more than once. So,
and then mind you, and sometimes those situations end up turning into like long term situationships. You know what I mean?
A vibe is a vibe.
But like Whitney said though, we're adults. Mm-hmm. You're making an adult decision, so there's nothing wrong with making an adult decision. Like, if you choose to do it, it is what it is. Now, what fucks it up is when, if you do it numerous times, like throughout a week or throughout, like, say you just meeting just random people, just fucking
my vagina has
that's the issue. That's the issue right there, you know what I'm saying?
So you say multiple people?
Now, that's the issue. There's nothing wrong with meeting someone and taking them down, but meeting someone and then meeting someone and then meeting someone and then meeting and taking it and then all of them taking them, that's the issue. That's the issue. You know what I'm saying? That's the problem. You know what I'm saying? So, but
have y'all ever been with it? So, yes, like, even if you, like he said, like, you actually you chilling with somebody for a while or whatever, stuff like that. Like, well, not really that. Like, you know them for a minute and you still make them wait. Like, why would you make them wait and you knew them for, like, a little minute? Is it because, like, oh, I don't want to ruin this by fucking with them? And
yeah,
then
sometimes. It depends on the person, but
I think society got in their head about that. Like, no. Oh, you got away. Oh, you're a hoe if you do this. Oh, like, they think about being labeled too much instead of just going with the flow, going with they feel.
Yeah, to be judged. I'm not judging you.
And it'd be a lot of times it'd be past situation. They fucked the nigga and it wasn't worth it.
Somebody said to you, Tom, when you was like, oh, you fucked multiple times throughout the week with different random people, you for the street.
You for the street.
You're not lying. You're not lying.
Give it up to the streets. Streets got this one. Have a few.
No, but it's like some, and then like you got some people, and you do have some people, and I know these people that I know. I can't say no names because a lot of people tell me they motherfucking business. Y'all can still tell me it's all right. I'm just using y'all as my motivation for these shows and shit. But I ain't gonna say no names. But I got some people that is for the streets, for the fucking streets. But then when they meet somebody, oh, I'm gonna wait. Nigga, bitch, you just fucked that nigga yesterday. Like, what you waiting for?
They selective about who they getting into, who they waiting for.
It's but like, some people don't. Special. Some people don't. You know, sex to them is they think it's sex different. So it's like, all right, I'm gonna make this one wait because I want him to think of me differently. Mm-hmm. I don't want him to look at me as a little as a whole, whatever, mm-hmm. whatever. So they might make that one wait. So it's like, it is what it is to me.
Somebody said you better stop listening to Steve Harvey. Do what works for you.
Facts. Don't listen to Steve Harvey.
That 98
shit. What? 98. Y'all talking about, man. Like, feel them out. Feel the person out. If you feeling, if you vibing with that person, it is what it is. If it happens, it happens.
Yo, chills. You might have a one night stand over here, son. I'm saying it's chills for me.
Look. You got fans, chills. You got fans, chills. You got fans.
Hashtag Buffett.
Yo,
we got Sheik Luch, Buff Daddy. Yo, Chill's been getting it the whole since we got here, so it is what it is. We used to it right now. But listen, like I said, Phil.
But like seriously, people out. There's a lot of people out. Ooh, the numbers going up.
That's our question. So, you fuck somebody on the first time, and that shit is whack. Does that factor into fucking porn?
It depends. If I liked him previously and it was like, we got a vibe, I'll give him like 3 tries. But if I didn't really like him, it's a one time. Like, one strike and you're out, buddy. You're out of here.
If I barely liked you,
yeah,
and then the buns is trash, and then the neck is horrible, I'm erasing everything about her. Right? It's a hold up. She's not getting a question. It's quiet, man.
She going to the blacklist, huh? She going to blacklist. She going to blacklist.
She going to the black party, absolutely.
The black party.
Yo, Chills, they called you Big Sexy, bro.
Appreciate it, thank you.
You might have one out here, man.
It's really hot to stop, yo. I get Buff Daddy after this.
That's funny. Like, they call me Big Sexy, though.
So if somebody says, like, you know, like she said, like, God forbid, they, like, if they actually was feeling them or whatever, and it was actually whack, they'll get one more.
All right, if I'm digging you, then I'll give you a chance. Yeah. I'll definitely give you. But what if
it could have been an off then you make a decision at that point.
No, but you gotta see, there's a lot of things that play a factor, because honestly, I ain't gonna lie, drunk. I was just about to say that sometimes when y'all actually have sex the first time and y'all the liquor is hitting y'all, that intoxicated sex is different.
All the excitement,
you know what I mean? And it's
it could be the excitement.
And
like,
one, you gotta realize too, and I'm not gonna say it's like this with me or whatever. This is like, I have questioned a lot of people. I be asking people a lot of sexual weird fucking questions. When alcohol plays a part, it takes longer for you to come.
Mm-hmm.
It does.
Then you think you all inadequate and shit, but the nigga done he all Kenny, so you like, oh, that's why
you
so long.
You got that any dick.
Yeah,
some of that any dick.
Don't let he fucking either be drinking, be smoking, or have fucking edibles, my nigga. First of all,
mother of two sessions need to be intoxicated to fuck. I feel you. You shouldn't have to be intoxicated to fuck. Like, you should be. Anybody should be able to just fuck. Like, let me tell you something. Back in my day, right? I used to sell e-pills, right? Be putting it out there.
Here we go.
Back in the day, right? So, a couple of my niggas used to take them, right?
Mm-hmm.
They used to be like, yo, you need to fuck on these shits. You need to fuck on these. The best sex you ever had.
Forever?
The best sex you ever had. I'm like, yo, my nigga, I don't need no fucking e-pills to fuck. I can fuck, bro. Like, I don't need no e-pills, my nigga. Like, give me some. What the fuck you talking about? That shit is crazy. People really need shit to fuck.
Mm.
Some people got to be either high, drunk, something to fuck. That's a natural thing. Fucking. It's natural.
And
fuck.
A lot of times, I'm not trying to go into the other topic, but a lot of times when you're intoxicated, and I mean intoxicated, whether it's alcohol, drugs, or whatever, it's actually harder to orgasm.
That's a fact.
It's harder to reach it's harder to orgasm. It's harder to reach a climax or whatever. And you're literally just fucking basically doing mad cardio. Unnecessary motherfucking
it's
cardio.
It's a great workout. Sex is a great workout. Sex is a great workout.
You know, we got time for that.
dripping sweat. Right.
Oh yeah, and I'm a sweater too, so I hate that shit. I be sweating my. Yo, let me tell you something, yo. Oh my god, that drunk sex. Oh, yeah, we ain't gonna talk about it. Yeah. Let's stop me now. I got one cup in me already, so.
It was like back in the day equals 10 minutes.
stupid.
Nah, some people said, and one person said they love that 2 or 3 hour workout. Yeah. Not
two
for me, kid.
Who
not
is
for
three?
Me, kid.
That's just for that long, though. Not me.
Not for me, kid.
Not me.
Not for me, kid. Listen, we got to cut this.
Broke.
You get 2 or 3, we good.
No.
You get 2 or 3 tomorrow, one on
straight. Now, at this point, at the second hour mark, that means you got the pillows under your stomach. Listen, I ain't getting on my knees.
We better have some intermissions in between, the fuck.
Right, so now you got props
So, ladies. Okay. Okay, what's time frame?
20 minutes. That's good. 20 minutes is good for me. 30 minutes, sometimes.
But you got nothing in 20 minutes.
Yeah, or it just got to be, it could be, 20 minutes is good. 30 minutes.
I'm within an hour or less. Like, no more than an hour.
Because we do
my whole thing, is like within an hour.
How many times you come in? How many times you come in?
Okay, that's fine.
But it's not really no break. It's a fuck you come, you take a drink, you got your drink, take a sip. All right, we clean up real quick. Boom, back to the next one. Like it's not no quick.
No, like watch.
So what if you come? What if you come multiple times?
Hold on, how many times you come in within that hour though?
It's fucking high, like.
See, and this is what I'm talking about 3-4 shows ago when I said y'all are some selfish beings, yo. Y'all are selfish.
But you have a problem,
though. How many times did you come within an hour? And he comes at one time, now you want him to get back up and make you come 4, 5, 6, 7 times again. He came one time. You came like 8 times just now.
And you still want to go after that?
But I'm making him come too.
One time!
No, he's coming multiple times. I'm trying to tell you.
He's coming twice. You said 2 sessions. He's coming 2 times. And you came like 10 times already. How selfish are you?
Seriously?
Yes, I'm serious.
You don't see that, though? You don't see that being selfish?
No, because that's just how your bodies is made of, and that's how our bodies is made of.
Exactly.
That's not our fault.
We can have multiple orgasms back to back.
Correct.
You guys literally only come one time. Oh, whatever,
I'm done. I need a break.
But you don't see us sweating our ass off, getting there and having an asthma attack, and now y'all just want us to get a drink and then do the same thing all over again?
No,
and you know the second nut takes longer to come out?
Get your inhaler.
You know that second? Well, for me, at least that second nut takes forever to come out. So you want me to do this again now?
Yep.
Y'all bugging.
But with this particular person I actually am speaking of, literally when he comes, he's hard automatically again. So it's like, what the fuck? Why leave him like that? That's selfish for fucking me to leave.
I'm not him, bro. That is selfish of me to leave this man with a hard fucking penis
and me not getting this shit the fuck down.
And gets back up on the phone. Mm-hmm. Something. But as if I'm really like on some like, yo, you know what? But for the most part, it's like, yo. We talked about the fake coming already. We spoke about that. You know how many times I know fake came? Like, yo.
I did that one time, bro. That
one time.
Right?
I do that. Listen, that is a norm.
Bro.
That's sad if that's your norm, bro.
You know why? Because that second nut takes forever and y'all are so selfish. My second nut takes forever to come out. I'm not going to be sitting there fucking you all night. You all over the place. And I'm sitting there like, okay, when is this going to come out? When is it going to come out? I can't.
Change positions. Fucking.
We do all of it.
Hang out the window. I don't know. Fucking you, go to the kitchen. Change scenery. That's right.
My second nut takes forever.
Take it to the shower.
Shower sex is
mad overrated. That's
bro.
Overrated.
I'm just saying. I'm just saying.
Change scenery.
Now you know
my hair. Where's somebody getting cold?
You know what's so funny though? You know what makes me come faster? When a chick tells me to come, like come, nigga, let it out. Come. That shit makes okay, I'm out. For some reason, I don't know why. I could be going in, but once she starts telling me, like, oh shit, there you go. Let's go.
And then she's like, I really didn't mean that. Like, I didn't.
Oh, no, she meant it because she done came like, fuck. Believe me, it's meant because it's like, nigga, please come. My second nut takes forever. I hate that shit. And I'm a sweater, too. So That shit is like, yo, what the fuck, my nigga? Like, I don't even be burning on these calories right now. Like, this shit is a full, like, this is a full cardio workout. And I got a fast metabolism. So I'm just like, oh my fucking God. This shit is crazy.
Somebody said, happy God designed me the way that he did. The multiples make me OD easy.
Break out the ring. I'm a champ. But go ahead.
What else? I'm trying to read down. Sorry, guys. I don't like being rushed. Somebody said, I don't like being rushed, so I'm going to fake it and finish it in the bathroom only. Nigga, you going to finish it by yourself in the bathroom?
That's mad way.
No, okay. I'm not doing that. Let me say something. All right, boom. If I get one out, this is me. This is not every nigga. This is me. Okay. I came. You done came mad times.
Okay, but would you do like what he said, like you're faking and going to the bathroom real quick?
No, I'm not doing that. What's the point of me fucking faking it then? I might as well let it out in you.
But I don't know who I can't read the.
I'm not going to fake it and then go finish it. I'm going to fake it and then go to sleep or some shit. Like, what the fuck? Go smoke or some shit. I'm finished.
This particular person that says, like, they'll fake it and go to the bathroom and finish it, whatever. People like that is like, oh, her pussy was whack. Yo, I mean, it's like, you know, let me just finish it. I can do better.
I never fake it off the first one, though. It's always the second one. It's always the second one. The first one's going to come out.
But the second one, it might be a fake one. Copy.
That's a fact. No, I'm lying. I have fake with the first one. I'm lying. But let's go. All right. Sometimes, like homie said, the pussy might be whack. So he's like, yo, I'm out of here.
No, I'm just saying. I'm just assuming because if you're going to fake it and then go finish it in the bathroom.
I've never done that, though. I've never finished it on my own. Like, on some, like, oh, I'm going to fake it and then go. Nah, I've never done that.
I just stopped. If I'm hard enough to like, all right, well, if you won't keep coming, that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
I know my body. I know I'm not gonna come, so I'll let you get yours. I'm like, yo, you good? All right, cool. I want a bathroom bottle. Oh, you ain't come? No, I'm good. I'm perfectly fine with that. But for some reason, women feel like, oh my God, I didn't make you come. You didn't have to make me come. I'm good. Why is that?
Because then you feel mad and inadequate. Like, did I do a good job? And I'm thinking about, like, I know I fucking did what I need to
do. Nah, you can't front though. Dudes are the same way. Well, most dudes are the same way. I can't say that. Because I've heard some stories from y'all females, and I'm sorry that y'all didn't fuck with a lot of these niggas out here. But some dudes think, like, damn, I didn't make her come. The fuck? Fuck, like, damn, I did something wrong.
Some guys feel inadequate when
your goal should be.
And the thing is that ladies be lying too. But the thing is that if guys are experienced in sex, they can feel when a woman is coming and or orgasm because you clench up, you feel the pulsating, you feel the tightening, you feel all that.
Like, fuck all the noise. That noise don't mean or whatever. Shit.
But it's like so, and then they still have to ask that dumbass question. Yo, how many times did you come?
Real talk. Some of y'all just be coming. You ever had one of them long comes that they be doing? Like I'm coming still.
Absolutely.
Them long comes be crazy.
You be sensitive after that.
Them long comes be crazy. Like, yo, that ain't normal. You're mutant or some shit?
Like, shake him.
Nah, but it's different strokes for different folks at the end of the day. Different, you know what I'm saying? Different people get pleased by different things. It takes, some people might take more. Some people can just take there's girls out there, you damn it just put the head in and they ready to come. It's different for different people. Some of you gotta really put work in, like, yo. Oh, you going to fucking come, motherfucker. Like, I'll be damned if you don't come in this motherfucker. Like, sometimes you got, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes you really got to put work in.
Somebody says, like, the come is the merit badge. And, like, that's they badge of honor. Like, oh, she came, son, y'all.
Let me tell you something. All right, let me ask y'all a question. You think it's, I don't know how it's going to come off this question. It might sound crazy. Do you think it's easier for a man or a woman to orgasm, not come, but to orgasm?
That's a different
Wrong topic. Going back to the
he's skipping ahead. He excited.
Listen.
Skipping ahead. We're not doing that right now.
I pre-came.
That was a good one.
I pre-came. Look, little bit just came out just now. Pardon me. You're not that pre-come to get you pregnant too, though. Watch out now. That pre-come is potent.
Nah, somebody said though, I'm trying to interact. Listen, again, let me redo the number, and it's on the screen. If you guys want to call, if you have some insight on the first date or weight or, you know, the sexual things going on in the conversation, you'll call in at 929-441-2417. The number again is 929-441-2417. But anyway, going back to these comments though.
Yo, chill.
Somebody said that.
Says hi.
Hello.
He about to, yo, we're going to do a dating game with Chills like one of these episodes.
Nah, that's the. No, not me. I'm not supposed to be here now.
Somebody says like they need to see the source from Shorty to know that she fucking coming. So like, but then I mind you, okay. With this comment, you remember when I forgot what show, we did a lot of shows
about the creaming.
That's just friction.
That shit don't mean nothing.
So if you think it's the friction, it's really not the girl coming. It's two different things. If you actually see her creaming, that doesn't mean
coming.
It just look like.
Listen, don't pay attention to noise or that or that what's man shit, man.
It's
the fact. The pulsating, the tightening.
The body is the body. The body will talk to you when you will feel it. Like you will feel it.
You know when a woman's come. You should know. And some women come multiple times, back to back. So it could be a little misguided sometimes, but listen, fella, you know when you're putting in work or she's faking it or not, man.
Like, somebody said it's whipped cream. And it says, I turn into Wolverine as soon as he's in it. All right.
Okay.
That shit hurts.
That shit hurts.
That Wolverine shit, you'd be like, oh my God.
Scratches on your back, scratches all over you.
Oh, okay,
that shit's crazy.
Yeah.
Once it goes in, I'm like,
yeah,
fuck, I didn't sign up for this.
You gotta slap
him. I did not sign up for this. All right, so
you might break her hand with that head.
Listen.
That hurts. No.
I can't.
Listen, this is what we do.
Sorry.
This is what we do here. This is sex, love, and alcohol, right?
As somebody says they gotta go by her body shivering, that's hard to fake. No, it ain't hard to fake.
Body shivering ain't hard to fake.
Big legs, little bit.
As easy as for me to fake it, they can fake it. Let me tell you, I do all of that shit too. I do all of that shit, so it's not hard to fake at all. So don't go by that.
Yo, I ain't gonna lie. I fake some shit so long, I fucking
you forgot. Oh my bad.
I'm faking.
Oh girl, you still coming, girl? Yo, I fake some shit so long to the point like you thinking about it, and then next thing you know, you get real silent in your head, and then you hear, "You all right?"
I'm done.
Yo,
nah.
Then I'm like, yo, you're like, yo, you
all right?
I'm like, oh yeah.
Sometimes I don't fake it. Sometimes I just keep it real. Like, yo, I'm finished. I'm tired. I'm hot.
I'm done.
Sometimes I'm done.
Like when
especially
I'm done,
if I know you done came, if I know you came, I gotta know you came first. If I know you came and I didn't come yet, sometimes you're just like, all right, whew, okay, all right, I'm finished. I'm
tired. I want on people like, damn, you ain't come yet? Yeah. All right. And I say it again. Still? You know what? You take mad long to come, sir. And I'd be like, I'd be one, like, kind of flipping my leg over, like, all right.
See, and that's what I'm talking about. No, okay. In that situation, when you're asking them all of that shit.
It's like, nigga, get off of me. I don't want to say get off of me, but I'm asking you 20 times. Nigga, you ain't come yet? What take you so long?
Well, I just say at that point, I'd be like, all right, let's go into mission. And then they'd be like, all right. And then
I pull the covers.
Yeah, when you get ready. Or go to sleep. And they do it again in the morning. Sounds good, right?
Y'all motherfuckers are selfish, bro. I swear to God, y'all are selfish. Like, it is what it is, though. Oh, shit, but you hot?
I'm hot. I just said that. It's hot in here.
Oh.
Whitney
and Chills over here matching tats. Put your arms together. Let me see that. Oh, shit. Look at Whitney and Chill. Look at that.
Is that sweat?
Oh, he nervous. You're making him nervous, Whitney. You're making this man nervous over here. What you doing to that man?
My bad, sir.
Huh? What's going on under that table?
Nothing.
Huh? I'm just making sure. Gotta be a referee over here.
I can actually agree with BJ. I think her name is. She says, when I like a dude, it doesn't take long. He knows which buttons to push. No, like, I ain't gonna lie.
So
if I really
not you liking that, a like, dude if, affects how you fuck him. Not how not how you fuck him, but how it feels.
If you're more in tune, like you like, yo, this it's shit is, yeah,
right.
Like, ooh.
Okay, right. I agree. So boom, 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 boom. Okay.
Wait, let's hold that thought. You know, we a real podcast, so we got a break sign.
We got commercials.
We got to
pay the bills.
Stay tuned after the commercial.
We're going to pay these bills and we'll be back, y'all.
Looking to podcast shows and do not know where to start? The Evening Rush Network can help you with that. Call us at 929-441-2417 or email us at theeveningrushnetwork@gmail.com for dates and prices. We got you for all your podcast needs. The Evening Rush Network. Tune in, subscribe, and share.
What's up, y'all? Your boy Shice, Mr. Talk of the Town, letting you know now the Evening Rush Network now has the app. So catch it on the Google Play and the App Store, and you can catch all your podcasts like The Evening Rush, Let's Talk Crazy, The Queens of NYC, Sex, Love, and Alcohol Plug, TL Mac Fitness, I Am Nicole Clara, On Everything, and Getting to the Focus, and all in one place at the Evening Rush Network app. That's right. So catch all your favorite shows. What are you waiting for? Download it now.
Now a message from our sponsors. Hot Commodity Cosmetics and Lash Studios for all your accessories and cosmetic needs. Please follow them on Instagram at hotcommodity_cosmetics or visit their website at www.hotcommoditycosmetics.com. For all your West Indian and soul food needs, visit Jamaican Paradise, located at 1708 Sunrise Highway in Copec, New York. You can also visit them on Instagram at jamaican.paradise. Delivery services are available if you're in the Long Island area via Uber Eats, Grubhub, and DoorDash. So go follow them on Instagram at jamaican.paradise and check out their website at jamaicanparadisetogo.com to see their menu and all the catering needs and to order to go. Are you in need of a nice relaxing massage by a professional licensed massage therapist? Look no further. Check out Graceful Touch Massage on Instagram. They have Swedish deep tissue and sports massages and more. They have different packages, so check them out and see what you like. Follow them on Instagram at Graceful Touch Massage. And those are our sponsors of Sex, Love, and Alcohol.
Hey, what's up, you guys, and we're back. Commercial break. I'm so sorry, this is like so unprofessional.
You all right?
I just stuffed like a whole thing of chips in my fucking mouth, and then the fucking commercial went off. I'm so sorry. Let me swallow. Sorry, very rude. So that was our sponsors, and if you have like a business, if you want to promote yourself, promote your brand, promote your business, promote anything. And if you are a party promoter and you want to promote your upcoming events, your upcoming parties, and stuff like that, or you can promote yourself if you even a new, like, what's some people called? Like, influencer on, like, social media and you want to promote yourself, whatever. You know, you can DM us on Sex, Love, and Alcohol on the IG page. It's exactly how it sounds. I mean, exactly how it's spelled. Sex, Love, and Alcohol on Instagram. Or you can email us at Chrissy More, chrissymore.bookings@gmail.com. So for any inquiries, whatever, we have really good plans. You can do a monthly, a one-time thing, like a monthly plan. We have like a six-month plan. Mm-hmm. We have, and it comes with little perks and stuff too. So, you know, if you ever want to be a sponsor and promote your business, feel free to hit us up. You know, it's a good little thing we got going on here. And again, we are a syndicated podcast. We are heard on numerous, and I mean numerous, we heard nationwide, worldwide. We're on over like 20, well, not even 20, I want to say maybe like 30 different stations. So, you know, you will get the publicity, you will get the advertising, and you will be seen. So hit us up if you want to be a sponsor. And also too, if you like the show and you want to see the show keep going, feel free to donate to the show. You know what I mean? Hit up the Cash App at SLA Podcast, you know, on Cash App. You know, no, nothing too big or small. It can be 50 cents, could be a dollar, nobody, or whatever. You know, if you like the show, donate to the show to keep the show running. So, on that note,
yo,
back to Sex, Love, and Alcohol.
Hold on.
And I hope you guys like the show so far.
Hold
you know
on,
what I mean?
Hold on, hold on, hold on. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Before we go any further.
Yo, shout out to us. Shout out to us. We're doing a fucking hell of a job. I don't give a fuck what anybody says. We're doing a hell of a job. We've been on the road. We've been keeping this fucking train going. Shout out to Sex, Love, and Alcohol. You
and we're the number one podcast, kid.
Yo, listen.
Manifest that. No, but we are. We actually are the
number one. On this network. On the Evening Rush Network, we are the number one podcast.
On the Evening Rush Network, we are the number one.
And we're working our way up. We're working our way up. We're building followers every week, you know. Bless y'all. We appreciate y'all for following and interacting with us, talking to us, calling up, all of that, man. We appreciate all of that.
And also, you know, if you, hopefully you guys tuned in for the whole little commercial break. You know, we have about 10, 11 shows on the network that talks about different kind of stuff. Everybody's show is different and they have their own little thing. Some people, I do believe there might be a sports show coming soon, but like they have a current event. We have even like a lady that actually is like a Whitney. I'm not Whitney.
Wendy.
I got Whitney
Wendy
in my
Williams.
In my
like
brain.
A, like a Wendy Williams.
She's like a Wendy Williams, yes. You know, with
current
the celebrity
events,
talk.
And, all
and we have other ones that do current events. And then we got other ones that's like, you know, Black Lives Matter, like, you know, the activists
political.
And political, you know, whatever you like, we have somebody for you. So, you know what I mean? Always. So if you're not subscribed to the Ethan Rush Network, follow the Evening Rush Network on YouTube, and there's a lot of different shows that you can watch different days. Every single day, I think, except for Sunday, we got a show going on. So, you know what I mean? Tune in. You know what I mean? We all support each other.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we all one family here, but
That's
we also
fact.
Have completely different shows.
Right.
So,
and this
you
shit
might
right
like
here,
sex.
This shit right here is that Sex, Love, and Alcohol. This shit right here, I'm telling you, this shit right here is different. But we back on it.
But yeah, so subscribe to the Evening Rush Network on YouTube.
So we were talking.
Oh, and don't forget, download the app. We got an app, baby. We got an app. I'm just playing.
Oh,
let me
we
stop
got
being, let me
app.
Stop being like mad ghetto or anything. Yeah, let me stop.
We do. Is we got an app. Like the Evening
Rush Network app
call.
Is on Google Play and iTunes. So download that so you can see all your shows. And guess what? Everything is on there. Like, even though we live now, is there forever. You can always watch it. So tune in. Hi, caller. Welcome to Sex, Love,
hey,
and Alcohol.
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, guys. It's Aisha. How are y'all doing?
Aisha, what's good with you? How you doing, mama?
I'm okay. How are you guys doing?
Can't complain.
We doing good. What's going on?
Well, let's see. I want to say that as a woman,
mm-hmm.
and grown men, if you decide to date somebody, you just met somebody, and you want to have sex with them,
mm-hmm.
it's your choice.
That's a fact.
You know what I'm saying? I'm a grown woman. My pussy grown. His dick is grown.
Okay.
If you want to fuck, we can fuck.
What's your IG, baby?
Yo, you so stupid. Shut up.
Shit. That's my kind of talk right there. Let me stop.
You're
talking
this. That's
my opinion.
We want.
That's my opinion. And wait, one more thing.
Okay.
Well, a couple of things. One, us women, we're blessed to come multiple times. Y'all got to keep up. Y'all men are not blessed like that, but y'all got to keep up. Now, my thing is, a lot of y'all men, when it comes to sex, all y'all want to do is just put the dick in. Y'all got to, and before y'all put the dick in the pussy, you have to
make sure she's wet first. You know, you got to do the foreplay. Huh?
Come on.
Yeah, you got to do the foreplay.
Of course.
Most importantly, that pussy needs to be pulsating. If the pussy is not wet, drowning, and pulsating, she's not ready.
Yeah, I'm not going
to
hold
She's
you.
Not ready to
I'm not going
to
hold
See,
you.
I'm about,
I don't
I'm,
think
I'm
I've
a,
ever heard pussy said so much right? on this show before. I love you right now.
First of all, I guess I'm the nigga bitch in the room because
a lot of chicks get wet off a fucking dick.
No, but listen, not for nothing. You cannot let your dude go inside you with a dry motherfucking dick. You better fucking slob on that
right.
shit. First
right.
of all, make
hey,
sure that shit is...
That's
yes.
another
okay.
That's another thing. Women, they take it as a chore. I don't feel that my fucking dick should be a chore.
Hell no, that shit is a luxury. You better fuck that shit.
Exactly.
Fuck Fuck y'all talking about? This is not 1952. This ain't the back in the day. This is 2021. Y'all suck dick nowadays. And be proud of it. Be proud of a dick in your mouth.
Exactly.
That's what I'm talking about.
The majority of women are dead fishes and they don't like sucking dick. And most men, they nasty as a motherfucker. They just want to eat some pussy. It doesn't even matter how dirty it is. That's how I feel.
Yeah, that's nasty. You're just eating random pussy?
Yes, most niggas is like that. And they just want to throw the dick in.
No. Don't tell me. Niggas is out here just eating whatever?
All
right. Yo, mama, we appreciate you calling. We appreciate the love. Call up another time. Thank you.
I want to shout out my brother. Hi, Charles. Keisha. Hi, Bubu.
And he definitely said he's telling your mama.
Facts.
Just let you know, FYI. So, you know.
This is crazy. That's
King
what's
of
up.
Connor.
Yo, if anybody wants to call in and interact with us, again, the number is 929-441-2417. So even if you want to just call and say what up. You know, I'm still going to ask you a question, though, but just call and say what up. But, yes.
Just remember, it's 2021, ladies. Do not be ashamed of sucking dick, all right? It's just a dick.
This show is giving me a migraine. Like,
I'm just saying. Well, then, IJS, all right?
All right, so I don't know if you, I told you, remember your fucking question, nigga.
Oh, let's go back to our previous topic. We were talking about if you like someone and does it affect the feeling. So, okay, you like someone, you're feeling them. Oh, I'm feeling this person. We've been talking for a minute. Oh, I'm feeling him. Oh, y'all fucking is trash. Now, you fucking him. He's like, you're sitting there like, now, because you like him, is that going to make it better for you?
No, and
you just finished saying if you like someone's gonna make it feel better.
No,
and
no,
we didn't say it makes it feel better.
That's what I asked
this
you.
Might make no. him get a couple more tries, but it ain't gonna make it feel better if I don't feel it. If I'm not, you know. But if I like him, I like him. I can still like him and it'll
not
be
fuck
that
him.
Great. Yeah.
I can ask you a question.
I had somebody ask me
if the
why
head
did
is...
I have a sex again? I said because your sex was trash.
If the head is better than the sex.
Oh, I don't like head, so that wouldn't be.
You don't like getting your pussy here?
No. That's a first.
Okay, you're
I'm
a unicorn.
I'm more of a pleaser than a giver. I mean, yeah, pleaser than a giver.
You'd rather suck dick than
I'd
rather
give. Give than, yeah.
You're some fucking love.
You
fucking love, Whitney.
Like, it gotta be like a holiday.
Give my man some love. Like, give my man Buff Daddy over there some fucking love.
If it's my birthday.
This is a porn star in the making right here, man. We gonna get you into porn.
We still live a spicy. I might let it happen, but it's not a prerequisite.
Somebody
I've had some good shit before, but I don't feel in control, so that's why I don't like it.
Oh,
it's a control.
Yeah, it's a control.
Thing.
I'm a Leo, so you know.
Oh, interesting.
On that way, I said, Yeah.
Somebody said she sounds immature, and not think. How is she immature? She wants to please you, and she don't want you going down on her.
Right.
I've come across a lot of females like that.
Yeah, they don't like.
I've come across a lot of females like that. Where they will just every time we've had sex, it's them giving me head, and I didn't have to do anything.
You ever found one that comes off a head?
Yes.
Yo, I had one squirt giving me
one?
Head.
One?
Like,
nigga, one?
Yeah, there's one. Squirting or head? Yeah, one. But women that come
nigga,
off
a head. That is a beautiful thing. Like, let me tell you something. I'm setting the scene
okay.
Right now.
You want to get out,
I'm setting the scene. When y'all start moaning, why y'all start?
You know, we're on Pandora and iHeart. They can't see any of this.
YouTube can. YouTube, listen. I love my YouTube people that's watching us right now and seeing this, all of this fuckery that's going on between us. I love it.
But they can't see your get out, sir.
The YouTube people can. Not the Pandora people.
All right,
watch us on
question.
YouTube.
Get your
Come
question.
On that.
Get your question.
On your computer. But when y'all, it wasn't a question. It was a statement. When y'all start moaning and stuff during head, when y'all giving us head, that right there is the sexiest fucking thing a man. Let me tell you, fuck moaning during sex. Fuck moaning during sex. When y'all are moaning while y'all are sucking our dicks, oh my God, that's something totally different. It's different. Because you're not faking that. You're not faking that. You're moaning because you love that what you're doing right now. You're enjoying that. That's a satisfaction, like, oh my God, I love sucking this dick moan.
You're sucking my dick not for me. You're sucking my dick for you.
For you. This is for your satisfaction. Now, that moan is beautiful.
That shit activates God moan.
Beautiful right there. Like, the moan during sex should be like, all right, she's just moaning, whatever. She might just want to make me come with her. But that moan during head? Oh,
you
know, my God.
Just suck your
yes.
Start looking at their
yes.
Feet like,
I have.
Like it's a
you're about to finish the question. Yes, I have.
There we go. I can't. I had actually, for all those who do follow me on social media, I do try to put up, like, questions and things pertaining to the show, the upcoming show for the week. And this week, I actually did exactly what you guys are talking about. I put up... this week, I actually put up, do people rather be pleased, rather be the pleaser or pleasing?
Mm.
And I actually read a study that says that about 70% of people rather do the pleasing because they actually get off on pleasing. They don't want to be pleased. Like, a lot of people actually rather be the pleaser, like actually doing the work, like going down. And that's for male and female, because they actually get aroused off of that. It makes them come. I had dudes come off a fucking giving head.
I did that once.
Word?
I've done that once.
They come just by eating out without even touching their penis.
You understand?
Like, it's a thing. It happens. And women too, they will literally have like a little orgasm by
I need clarification right now. I need clarification right now because I doesn't like
no
what
nothing.
Type
no like
it don't you need that type of for a man to get that off?
I guess he
personally is. For me, that particular moment, my mental was gone. Like, shorty's losing her mind. I'm sitting there eating it.
And listen, you can be eating it, and guess what? She's coming and or squirting while you coming.
Oh,
and you
I
don't
understand
even have to
the female coming from it, but...
No, but it's like, it's a thing that turns
dude?
On.
I'm
living
proof. I'm
not
holding it. One time, bro. It only happened once. And I still don't know how the fuck it happened. I just know what happened. I was like...
Good for you.
It happens.
Hold on. So while you was eating it, you must have been rubbing against a bed or something, or rubbing against a sheet.
You don't have to touch your penis to come. You do know that, right?
I know this.
Right, because in a wet dream, you don't. You're not touching yourself.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah. I ain't never have a wet dream before, but if I was like 12, but it is what it is. It's like, I don't know. I guess I need that some type of... I'm not going to get turned on that much with eating pussy.
The thing is that I like this show because everybody has a different point of view. And the thing is that everybody doesn't do everything.
I can't do that shit now, bro.
You said I was younger. How old was you?
Shit, what was I? I say like 24, 25.
But you were still like a grown man.
Yeah, I was, but I'm grown now. I'm growner.
You're growner.
I'm growner.
That's right. You're growner.
The word of the night.
He's growner.
That was the pre-gym. I was pre-gym chills.
Right.
That's before we started going to the gym.
That's
gym the gym
that's
stopped that for him.
Fact.
The gym stopped
that's
that for him,
fact.
Y'all.
Hell yeah.
Gym stopped that for him. That's crazy.
They say you've grown now, son. You've grown, son.
I'm big grown, yeah, man.
So you know
you big grown. You're not little grown, son. Mm-hmm. You're not little grown. You're the big grown version. Yo, this show's crazy. But
this show is the shit. But we got more topics to talk about. That's the crazy part. We have more topics to talk about. Want to start getting them?
I'm going there. I'm getting there, baby. I'm getting there.
Trace
them. Has anybody? Okay, sorry. Again, I did some Q&As on Instagram again about threesome/foursomes. Has anybody, again, audience people tune in, have you ever had a threesome or foursome, or is it not even for you? You're not even about that life. A lot of people, it was like a half and half type of thing, but it was a lot of people that actually answered. Like, sometimes people don't be fucking answering my motherfucking questions, but people answered this week. But it was a lot. It's half and half. But some people, the ones that said no, some of the ones that said no, I know them. Some of the ones, I don't know them. But so the ones that I kind of know that said no, the reason why they said no, because they don't like to share. Okay? And they don't, it's not, and, or they, I don't want to say they don't like to share, and or they have like trust issues with their partner to the point that they feel like if they do have a threesome or whatever, that, you know, the partner,
the other person.
Exactly. Yeah. You understand? And then the ones that do have threesomes, whatever, it's like, I want to say they're more secure with themselves and more confident with themselves to say, you know what, like, you know, I trust my partner or whatever, or some people don't even, it's not even, I can't even say it's just partners or relationships, because some people just have threesomes, just have fucking threesomes. They meet some, like, they have a homegirl, like, yo, whatever. Like me, like me personally, she's probably watching. I have a really good friend. We know what each other tastes like. Okay. She tastes awesome. And I taste awesome. And we used to.
I taste awesome.
Yes, I taste myself, baby. You gotta know what you can't have somebody going down with you. You know what the fuck you taste like, my nigga. And when you in me, come up here, so let me lick that shit off for you, son. Let me lick that shit off for you, baby. Let me stop. I'm just saying. That's
it. So hold on. The question, baby. You ever had a threesome before, Whitney?
I guess you would call it a threesome. I feel like we ran a train on the dude because it was two of us. We kissed. We didn't like eat each other out or nothing. But we did, we had a nigga and we just took turns and we were kissing each other, touching each other. But that happened twice. So.
Yeah, two.
So,
laying a girl okay, so and since, a guy.
So, since I'm like, I don't want to say experience, but I know my shit. First of all, I have to go into the question.
Go ahead.
So, since you didn't taste her and she didn't taste you, were you, I'm just going to say you was fucking him, but he was tasting one of you guys?
Yeah.
Okay, then at least that okay.
Yeah,
works.
That happens. So
that works. That works.
Yo, Chiz, you got threesome, Chiz?
I don't know if you want to call it a threesome. I had two chicks stop me off. I didn't penetrate neither one of them.
I don't fucking threesome, bro.
I ain't a threesome then. I have a threesome.
All right, so.
I get offers, but I ain't
so I'm clearly guessing that your answer is yes.
I'm not built for that.
I've had
multiple.
No. I've had a couple.
Okay. All right. You multiple.
But I've had a bad threesome before, though.
Okay. What was the bad threesome?
How can threesomes be bad?
Fucking threesome, like, though. All right.
You so got two people to choose from. How the shit bad?
Right,
if one whack, you fucking just focus on the other one.
All right. So that. All right.
Let the other one do that.
That's what made it a bad threesome. That's what made it a bad threesome. All right, this is what happened. This is what happened. And this is real.
Suck on a nipple or something. I don't know.
Leave me alone. A chick I already fucked, right? Boom. I already did me with her. She actually, we brought up the whole threesome thing, like, yo, my homegirl, blah, 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 blah. I agreed to it. Like, all right, let's do this, make it happen. Go pick up the homegirl. The homegirl.
Oh, wait, so your person was, and then you saw it was like, oh.
No, Pinky and the homegirl bad, so I'm
yeah, like, hell
oh,
yeah.
I got both of them in the car now. We on the way to the crib. I'm like, oh, so when we get to the crib, right? We upstairs, we in the crib. Now, the chick that I already fucked starts popping me off.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm not getting hard. Oh, I'm not getting hard. So she starts feeling when she goes to the bathroom or some shit. The other chick starts popping me off.
And you getting hard.
Immediately, my shit is boom to the roof. Like, oh shit. So being her starts fucking. And the other chick feels a sort of way because she was like, damn, you know what I'm saying? So she just sits on the side of the bed while me and the other chick is fucking. So we're trying to get her into it. Like, yo, come on.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But she got an attitude.
Uh-huh.
So I finished me with the other chick, but it was a whack threesome. That's your name?
Technically, that wasn't even a threesome anymore.
Right.
Like,
you had a bully on the sideline.
Yeah, my dude
right here. We acted for this one.
That shit was crazy. I was like, yo.
Sure, she was bad.
But besides that, I've had regular. So let me ask y'all the questions, ladies, because I heard this a couple times. I've heard that dudes who get offered a lot of threesomes have whack dick. Is that true? What? I've heard because I've heard if you have good dick, the average woman don't want to share it.
I guess.
I want to share that shit. Listen, this shit I got to brag about. I'm going to brag about this motherfucker. Listen here.
I've heard this from numerous females that if the nigga's dick is good, they don't want to share it. It's, if it's average, it's like, all right, whatever. But if a nigga's dick is good, I don't want to share it.
I don't agree at all.
But sometimes, on a normal basis. Like some people, like if you just have like a threesome just to have it on some sporadic, like, okay, we out and about. But on a normal basis, like if we, y'all just, that's what y'all do is have, they say it's a lot of times because the nigga's dick is average. Because they say if it's good, you don't want to share it.
Nah. Yeah, why would you want to share whack dick? Who the fuck wants whack? Now you have a third person. It's just whacker.
But usually it's with someone you don't know.
Whacker. Like,
true.
Fuck? Usually it's with someone you don't know. We don't give a fuck. Like, maybe it's to get you off.
I'm going to have this bitch choke me like, yo. Maybe it's for the female. Like,
but maybe it's for the female just to get some pussy. Like, I'll entertain you with this threesome, but it's just for me to get my shit off with this other chick right here. Maybe it's that. Maybe it has nothing to do with the whack dick per se. I don't know. I don't know. Different strokes with it goes back to that. Different strokes with different folks.
Yeah, but anyway, back to my story when I was cut off. I have a friend that like we actually were in really good relationships, but it's like we were in the lifestyle, like say like the swinger lifestyle. But the thing is that like our partners actually enjoyed having sex with other people as well, and we allowed them to, but with us. So the thing is that now, like, you know, certain times she'd be like, yo, my boyfriend's coming over, whatever, you gonna come join us? Sure, why not? Same thing with me. Like, oh, you coming over? Join us? Yeah, whatever. So we would actually have sex with each other's boyfriends together.
I've done the whole thing.
To give them that threesome, you know what I mean? Because at the end, it's like, and I don't want to say like it was like a safer way because it's like, oh, I know she leave her nigga. Yeah. And I know you. It's like whatever. Yeah. But we also did have threesomes with other people, but it's like we had more threesomes with each other.
Because I'm comfortable.
Yeah. Right. And it's like we knew each other's bodies and what made each other. So it made, and then we both were fucking OD freaky people. So we just did some extra shit. So it's like, you know. I don't know. It works like that.
So it was just foursomes then?
No. Like me, her, and her man, and then us and my man. Like it wasn't never the four of us.
Never four at the same time.
It was either she was with me and my man.
So why is that? I never had the foursome then. Why was it not all together? Like, oh, fuck it.
As a man,
you know, niggas don't want
to. No, I'm asking her that.
The only time I ever did, like, say, like, a foursome. I'm lying.
I don't want to foursome.
That's a fact.
I'm not foursome. I was asking her. Like,
no, I did foursomes at swinger events. I did foursomes at swinger events. I did foursomes, like, prior to me being married, I actually had a swinger buddy, a male swinger buddy, whatever, that he actually was dating a new person that was actually curious, whatever. And I was dating somebody that didn't mind. And, you know, to get her comfortable, we had like a little game night and kind of, we already plotted like, yo, we all fucking done. Well, she like, not we fucking. She got to deal with the shit. She gonna be fucking. Not, it wasn't rape. She ended up going with the flow. But it's like, you know, we ended up. I did the actual couple thing and I did the foursome where none of us were in relationships together. It was just four randoms. You know what I mean? At like a swinger event. But then the couple thing was actually good too because the couple one, the intimacy was so intense. Like it's a different thing when they actually are couples. Than rather four random people.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like the intimacy was insane. The thing, it was like, it was different. So yeah. Like,
what the fuck? Yo, where has this show gone? But, oh, I love it. I love it.
No, but it's the truth. It's
like truth. It's our truth. That's what we do. It's what, hey, that's what it is.
No, but it's like, it's different. But I was telling somebody on like Instagram, we were talking about, again, like the posts and stuff, whatever. Like I was telling like the couple foursomes is a different thing. I said, if you actually are in a relationship with somebody that you are actually secure with and you guys have that communication that, you know, this is what we're going to do and you find another couple that is willing to, when I say, I can't even really explain in detail like how intense it is, you want to do that shit every fucking week.
Really?
Like, the shit is that different. Like, it's different. It's that spicy. If you find somebody, like, I promise y'all gonna be best fucking friends. Y'all gonna be like, y'all gonna date night? Y'all ain't watch no movie. Y'all eat no food. Y'all
Most dudes, I'm not saying all because of obviously it's not all. Most dudes aren't comfortable with watching or being there while their girl is getting fucked by someone else. Okay. Most dudes don't want to see that, don't want to know about that, don't want to experience that.
That's what I said. Some people are not comfortable with it at all, but I feel like first of all, sex is taboo, period. So adding a third person into the mix is just like a fucking hell no to some people. It's like, don't even fucking try.
Yeah.
And the thing is that if a guy brings it up to a girl in their head, it's like, oh, he's cheating. Oh, he wanted whatever. But if a girl brings it up, it's so-called okay. I don't know what the fuck the difference is to people, whatever. But it's like some guys, you got to wait until your girl bring it up so that, because if you bring it up first, I'm guaranteeing your girl going to think you fucking cheating or you want to step out on your relationship or whatever. It's a stereotype. But if you want to have a threesome, allow your girl to bring it up or sit down and have that conversation.
Know your girl. Know what type of girl you have. Know her mindset and know if you can even bring up some shit like that with her.
That's your question.
You know what I'm saying? Some girls are like,
I know a few homies, a few homegirls, and their fantasy is to be fucked by two dudes. Is that y'all?
I mean, it used to be, because I always wanted, like, you know, one in the front, one in the back. But now I'll be like, nah.
To be honest, I watch a lot of porn, and it's like TV to me. Like, I always want...
like TV. Channel 11?
Yeah, just normalize sex here. It's called sex, love, and alcohol.
Like, I literally watch it when I can't sleep. Right? I'm like, oh, let me tell whatever. And I be laughing through the fucking, it's fucking weird.
That's what I gotta deal with.
Like,
bro.
But anyway, like, I like the double penetration shit. But the thing is, like, that's my fantasy shit.
I don't know, porn stars are getting paid for that shit, right?
Right.
If I agree to a threesome with two niggas and y'all don't want to put two in both my holes or whatever at the same motherfucking time, niggas, y'all gotta go.
Because then that would be like a train. Y'all just taking turns on me at that point. So it got to be at the same time.
There's no way.
That's how I used to be. But I just feel like now it's like whatever. Boho?
So hold on. So if you're doing it and then you touch.
But you watch enough porn to see it happen sometimes, but it's not like a.
When you're done, bro, there's no way if it's not. Because you're meat touch me, brother, bro.
But what's it, your brother?
If you're meat touch, I'm sorry.
If you're meat touch my meat, you're automatically gay.
I never had the two men at the same time, but I am a person that, like, if a guy is fucking my ass, I would definitely take a toy and stick it inside of me. So that I will have like the double thing. I'd rather two real ones. Like, real ones.
Can we touch on something right quick? I'm flabbergasted right now. I just want to say that right now. Like, I am in shock. I'm in awe. This is a moment right now, all right? You never had two guys at the same time?
No, I have had two guys at the same time, but not the double penetration thing. I had me sucking somebody big and somebody behind. Nigga, no, I need both y'all at the same time. You know what?
Now, let me ask you a question. So you had this situation where you sucking one and one ain't fucking you. Was it because of you that they didn't do the double trade, or because of them? They didn't want to. They didn't want to be too close to each other, right? It was just like
I had the same.
I had it with two guys, but they
weren't about to touch me. Like, they was not about to touch.
You did the same thing. You were sucking one, my one was fucking.
Correct, but yeah, they was not about to touch no damn me.
I'm about to deal with some white boys. The white boys ain't don't fuck me.
Right, you fucking right. You fucking right.
We're not doing that.
It was all shenanigans.
Pick me.
We're not doing that.
The white dudes.
But you really? So hold on. So hold on. Let me ask you something. So you want to be bent over? You want to have one nigga over you in your ass and the other nigga under him in your pussy?
Yes.
Or
the bone looks like a boxing boy shit.
No, it's literally, all right, let me explain. Let me roll you a picture.
That's some real, that's some mole shit right there, yo.
The guy and the man down.
It's a possibility. It's a possibility, though.
It's a possibility, but the hole is very close. But
I don't even want to climb on you right now. But the guy is laying down, and the girl is over them, and the guy is behind her. It's like the guy is doing doggy style. The top guy is doing doggy style. The girl is facing you, and you're laying down. Like, y'all might touch, but guess what? Y'all got to be in rhythm. If y'all in rhythm together, y'all ain't touching.
One in, one out.
Nah,
you ain't
got
to touch it.
Facts, bro. Like,
you gotta be comfortable with the people you
around. Nah, bro. It's fuck being comfortable. No, my nigga. No. It's not happening.
Yo, whack.
We're whack because we don't want to fucking sword fight. We're whack because we don't want to sword fight.
All right. Have y'all ever fucked a girl that actually pulled out a dildo or whatever and stuck it in so that y'all, whether she stuck in her anal and y'all was in her pussy, whatever, or vice versa?
I've had that before. A toy.
And how does that feel? And how does that feel to you? Because you feel the toy inside. You feel the penis. When you're in her ass, you feel the penis.
I've never in her ass.
Well, if you're in the vagina, she put the toy in her ass, you're going to feel it. And it's that pressure and it's squeezing on you. You understand?
It was a vibrator?
It was vibrating.
Okay.
And mind you,
it was in her ass?
No, I was in her. The vibrator was on her clit. There was nothing in her butt cheeks. Nothing between anal.
No, I tried it, but it's not my cup of tea. I am the motherfucking queen of it.
Listen,
there's this thing called...
Let me tell you something. Go ahead, talk your shit, love.
I am a backyardian, son. I am a backyardian.
Listen.
Were they names again? I forgot.
Uniqua was one of them. Yeah. No, like, I have, it's like, I have a really good...
Yeah, I was a ghetto one. I was a ghetto one.
What is that shit called? I have a really good anal ease. It's, like,
anal ease.
Yeah, I'm real sensitive
That's
to...
That's a term?
Yeah, anal ease.
Anal ease.
It is, right?
Yeah, definitely. Mind you, I got it from Amazon, y'all. It's like $9. It works.
Oh,
you get the.
It's called. It's a little called anal ease.
It's lube.
It's a brand, but if you put in I'm gonna say Amazon. Amazon, you know, come next day, get same day delivery. If you got shit to do on the weekend, I'm just trying to tell you, put y'all on.
Pay attention, y'all.
You put in anal ease in the search thing, and it's actually a blue and white bottle. Oh my God, I order all the time, and I'm having a brain fart. But it's water based. I have a sensitivity to a lot of different things. It's water-based, whatever. It's blue and white. It's a white wrapping with blue lettering, whatever.
So is it like blue?
And it's water-based. Yeah, but the thing is that you put it, and it comes with a, you have to get the inserter. It's like a blue little thing that looks like a thing.
Come on, you have a science product as fuck?
No, but you don't do it. The girl does it before you, but you got to be careful because it lasts about 8 to 9 fucking hours.
But how do you know when you're gonna fuck in the ass? Though
sometimes
that just happens.
You insert it. You won't know. I do that. When I know I'm gonna go fuck, and then my brain is like, no, this nigga's going in my ass today. I will do it at home.
You know what
nigga's
gonna go in your ass?
I'm gonna make them fucking go in my ass. Listen, I'm gonna do this shit at home before I leave my house. And a lot of times I have with me in my car. I will do it at home.
You ever had a nigga say no to go in your ass?
No, I never did.
Yo,
that's the same. That and it's water based.
It's
like,
anal lube and silicone implant.
But you don't feel it. It numbs you. It numbs you, but it doesn't make you. You don't contract. You don't feel like the tension, and it goes in with ease. You don't feel. You feel them fucking you, but you don't feel the pain of them going in and out.
It's like numbing cream when you get a tattoo.
Yes.
Oh.
But you feel the fucking, you feel the pressure, but you don't feel the pain of them going in.
So when it wears off, do you feel it?
How long does the pain last, though?
So you don't feel that at
all?
That's the question.
Okay. So like,
there's no
pain. I heard, I fuck the anal ease.
Oh, and without it, the pain lasts about 3-4 fucking days. That shit, because it takes a while for your muscles to go back to normal.
Your butthole to contract back.
Yes. It takes a little while. And then you be fucking shitting on yourself. Like, you fucking laugh too hard, you fucking shitting on your fucking self.
Oh, my God.
During,
how long, because I've heard different things. Some people say it's just off the initial, like once you put it in and then after, as you keep on going, like the pain, they get into
it.
The pain goes away. Some people say it hurts. All the way through.
Right, exactly.
Listen, when I tried it once on vacation. I tried it before that, but the time that I tried it, we was in DR, and I don't know, I was feeling spicy that night. And then my booty was bleeding the fucking whole time I was there. Yes. So I was like, I'm not.
Oh my God.
And that's without, and I'm never doing this again.
And that's only because your mind is making you tense up like that. But I'm trying to tell you, the anal. Like, everybody, the anal ease works, and the mind, and you don't have bleeding. It releases the sensitivity.
And how many minutes before, or how many hours?
You can do it up to like 15, 20 minutes before, but it works. It works pretty instantly.
What you
need? Okay. It works. I want to say a minimum of 15 minutes prior.
I'm lost. All right.
But once you, even if you do it, like say you do it 30 minutes before, like before you leave your house, it lasts for hours.
Mm.
It lasts for hours, so you're actually okay. Even if y'all go out, party, whatever, you good money.
You know at the next.
You good money.
You're putting it in my butt tonight. So
even funny. If you go sleep in the morning, you might be pushing it, but.
This show was crazy. Y'all got me on the wrong route, man. I did say I was an angel. I had a halo over my head before the show started. Like, we got another call.
Somebody calling.
Why another call? What's going on? What's going on?
In the booty.
I'm gonna start taking an ass. What's going on?
Hey, what's up? Welcome to Sex, Love, and Alcohol.
Yo, what's good? Who this?
Divinia.
Divinia, what's going on, Queen?
How you doing?
We all right. How are you?
Good, good, good.
Or talk your shit.
Y'all are hilarious ones.
Well, thank you, my dear.
Y'all are fucking hilarious.
We got you all fucked up. You can't even talk right now. Look at you.
Yeah.
No, listen, Divinia, listen. I have that effect of woman sometimes, you know.
Is that here we go? Here we go with the bullshit. We go with the bullshit.
At least we are aware of what's going on right now. So, we're having a good old time in the comments.
I see.
I can't even read all these shits. It's just going by mad fast. But I appreciate y'all. Thank you for even tuning in.
All right, what you got to talk about, though, Divinia? Talk your shit, love.
That's funny because I had ordered the anal ease and they actually had sent me something else on accident, so I never got it.
Wow, look at you. You better take it in the booty.
Somebody asked, like, if you take a doodle.
Wow. Yo, hold on.
Is it numb?
Yo,
is
hold
it numb
on.
When you
poop have you ever
after?
Shit? Have you ever
you
shit?
Don't
it?
Feel
why?
It.
Hold on.
You
have
don't
you ever
feel that the poop is?
Let me ask
you
a question. Ladies, ladies, ladies,
that's
ladies,
crazy.
Ladies, have y'all ever let out some shit while a nigga been fucking you in the ass?
No,
before?
But no.
I'm asking the caller too.
It feels like you got a doodle, but I didn't doodle.
No.
What if you do doodle?
That's happened before with me. But caller.
I'm turned
off. Divinia.
Yes.
We so sorry, love. We going all topic right now, but you ordered the anal ease, okay? We know that you have interest in having some anal sex. So, have you ever had anal sex before?
Yes, I have.
Without the easing.
I've done it. Oh, I've never used the anal ease. I've had it with and without lubricant.
Are you a fan?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so if you're a fan of it, then what's the point of getting the anal ease?
It makes it more pleasurable because it's less pain.
Okay.
See, there's a warm up time to it. Like, it helps numb you so you can get right into it.
Okay.
But I think people need to also understand whenever you're numb, you're not receiving like pain signals from your body, so you shouldn't just go crazy because you have to still worry
blood
about
blood vessels and all that stuff. Could be
what happens when this pain medication wears off? Am I going to feel like shit tomorrow? Like.
Literally.
You're actually okay. Yeah. I can say it's been years. I've been using it for a very long time, but when I first started, like literally, I was scared. I was like, "Oh God, what the fuck is shit gonna do to me?" or whatever. So I used like a little bit at a time, and the little bit at a time actually still worked, but it didn't last long.
You understand? So I kind of did like a trial and error. It's like, oh, I put a little bit, but it's like, oh, when actually we actually finished our date and got to the house, it's like, all right, it's wearing off.
Yeah, let me ask you a question.
I didn't want to. It's like, I don't know what it's going to do to me. You understand? So I tried a little bit of time, but it was enough for him to get the fuck in.
Yeah.
And once he was in, it's like,
so Chrissy, okay. I have one more question before we get you off the line, love. One quick question. So being that y'all both like anal, because I've heard females say they'd rather just stick it in my ass and then play with their clit while a nigga's fucking them in their ass. Would y'all rather that? Would y'all rather a nigga just fuck you in the ass and you play with your own clit?
Well, that goes in our next topic of having anal orgasms.
No, I prefer vaginal sex.
You prefer vaginal?
With a sprinkling of anal sometimes.
In between. Just a little salt bay of that little anal, right? Just a little salt bay of that anal. Yo, Davina, we appreciate you, Queen. We appreciate the support and everything. You heard, Joe?
Yes.
Call us anytime, you heard?
All right, good night, guys.
All right, have a good one, baby.
Bye.
You're ready.
I'm mad on Vigilant and Sprinkle, and I think
Yo.
That actually goes, it's like, I didn't have time to, like, write down all my things or whatever, but that actually goes into the different types of orgasms, though. It's like so you have good, the clitoral. That's the orgasm that everybody knows.
A lot of people
knows.
Say anal's the best.
I'm about to say, a lot of chicks say anal.
Have you ever had, for the gym, you're a dude, so you won't have it. Like, but females actually work out, there's actually a corgasm, where you actually have an orgasm from sit-ups and push-up doing, like,
I would say this, as a massage therapist.
We have another call.
As a massage therapist, I've had someone had an orgasm from massage before.
That's different.
Yo.
Welcome to Sex, Love, and Alcohol.
What's good with you?
How you doing? What's going on?
Yo, what's good, bro?
Yo.
Yo, my name is Esco. Yo, well, what's poppin', chub?
Who that?
Esco.
Yo,
Esco, what's good,
man? Oh, that's my cousin. What the fuck is shaking, my guy? What you doing over here,
bro? I'm calling.
Thank you. Talk your shit, bro.
What's good?
Oh, well, I don't know. I guess y'all probably might either be ahead of me, but I heard y'all talking about the whole anal shit and all that. Shit is crazy.
Go ahead. Talk your shit. What's your feeling on the topic, man? You fucking chicks in the ass or what, man?
I mean, I be fucking a few chicks in the ass. I mean, and it should be fire, though. I ain't gonna hold you. Because, like, what Shorty's saying about the anal coming, that's definitely way different than, you know, the pussy coming. Like,
that should be crazy. They be going in when they come off that ass shit, my nigga.
And it's actually anal orgasm, like that is some real shit.
It definitely feel a little weird when you first, you know, insert and all of that. But then afterwards, once you keep going, I mean, it starts getting a little gushy. It get real gushy.
Yo, my nigga, you ever got the dick shitted on, bro? Fuck your shit, you ever got the dick shitted on, bro?
Doodle dick, bro?
Nah, I ain't had the doodle dick.
Listen. Sometimes they give you the doodle dick, bro. Watch out for that, my nigga. Watch out for that, bro.
As soon as I'm done, then I got to, you know, lift the sack and scrub.
Like, you got to back out of that shit, bro. You can't finish. You got to back out of it. Yo, listen, some niggas will be finishing. They don't give a fuck. Back out of that shit, bro.
Cuzzo, if you get doodle dick, wash shit with hand sanitizer, bro. Good money, boy.
Right, now I'm gonna call those bleach, boy. All that shit.
Nah, you gotta use Clorox. Nigga, bleach that shit. Nigga, bleach it.
Bleach the meat. That's
what you can't pay. Hashtag bleach the meat.
About to make a shirt. Bleach the meat.
Fat hashtag that shit, man. That's what you talk about, man. But yo, my nigga. We appreciate the love, bro. You heard?
Cuzzo, man, when I got it, Cuzzo, I got you.
So I'm about to definitely say something to that cat.
Yo, keep fucking him in the ass, bro.
I can't.
You already.
Booty bandit, my nigga. There you go.
There you go.
Bleach the meat. Bleach the meat. Hashtag bleach the meat.
City staff out here, you feel me?
Oh, my God.
City staff.
Doodle dick. City staff. Bleach the meat. Hashtag. Go ahead. We're going viral for this one.
Where's my show going?
Straight to the motherfucking abortion clinic after this shit. Yeah, we going left. We going left with this one. We going left. Yo.
All right, let's go back into these orgasms though. The core orgasm is like actually physical exercise orgasm. When you're doing like push-ups and sit-ups and stuff like that, you can actually have an orgasm because you're working out your midsection. You're putting that pressure on like your, you know, all the little organs in there. It's contracted. You know what I mean?
What's your best?
My best?
What's your best? Out of all of the orgasms, what's your best? Anal, vaginal, clitoral.
I want to say, Jesus.
Vaginal, I don't know.
Well, I'm a fucking
vaginal. Vaginal, I said vaginal.
Well, I don't, God.
I'm three cups in.
I want to say my hardest orgasm was anal.
I knew she was going to say that.
My hardest orgasm, as in the point where I'm in tears crying because my body's still shaking after you're out of me.
And
the thing is that I don't know why I'm crying. It's just that my face is like, bitch, I can't stop the crying. Even if I'm
the
trying.
Pain mixed with the pleasure?
No, it's a weird shit.
She just
shit.
Said there was no pain with the booty.
Who knows she was using the booty bin at that time?
The anal easer.
My bad. The anal pleaser.
The booty bin. The booty bandit, though. The booty bandit.
We're going with our own product. So I'm marketing our own. Look, sex, love, and alcohol presents the booty bandit.
All right. We got the G-spot orgasm, the prostate orgasm.
The prostate orgasm?
Not doing that.
The prostate orgasm, okay, what else?
And then we got the blended orgasm, which is the combination of the G-spot, clitoris, anal type of thing, when it's a mixture. Well, the G-spot and the clitoris is basically the same thing because you're in the same fucking area. Yeah. But so say like the clitoral. I can't. Okay. I have this tongue. You know what I mean? That West Indian thing coming out, son.
I said vaginal. So what?
So the vagina orgasm and
vaginal.
I'm gonna
say
my leave because
you had a vagina.
It's vaginal.
Leave me, God. And then you have a full body orgasm. Oh my God! You have the anal orgasm, the C-spot orgasm, the nipple.
What is this?
Have you ever had an orgasm for somebody sucking on your nipple?
No, I get turned on, but not.
I've had that before, but not me have it. But I've experienced that someone having coming from me sucking. I'm like, what the? Are you normal? Right. Who does that?
That's a snap
effect. Off a nipple play?
You want to know something? And no offense to you, because you're a gym rat. I have dealt.
Like I'm targeted. I feel like
it's on
my back.
Yo, for all my gorillas out there, y'all know who the fuck y'all are. All y'all motherfuckers that be in the gym looking like motherfucking gorillas. I have had sex with people that are actually real life gorillas. And it's like they work out so much from like
I heard
like the testosterone. What's that thing? The testosterone, whatever.
Yeah.
It's like all their sensation is in their nipples, so they can't even get hard unless you suck on their nipples. Like they come from the nipple thing. It's like you gotta play on their nipples.
That's not me. I am not that guy. I enjoy the nipple licking. Don't get me wrong. You can deep throw
that.
That
don't do nothing for me. You could suck, lick my. I'm sitting here like.
And as big as my motherfucking titties are, don't touch my fucking titties.
Like, I don't like my nipples. I don't like my neck getting kissed. I don't like
nothing. You just fuck. Don't suck my motherfucking titties.
What?
I'm not a teacup. I'm a J. Thank you very much. I'm a J.
A J.
I'm a motherfucking J.
A nigga lose count after D. Like what the fuck? Like you get lost after D.
I'm a motherfucking J.
A J.
You have no
nipples
at all. You have no sensation in your nipples at all.
No, I have sensation. I just don't like it. Even like I have kids, like I couldn't even do breastfeeding. I don't like the way that it feels.
Mm.
Now, there's a lot of females like that. Don't,
I don't like the way it
feels.
But
me personally, like, as a dude, that shit does nothing for, do not fucking, like, you're wasting your time. You're sitting there looking, unless it's doing something for you, that shit is not doing nothing for me. Like, I guess we're the same.
First of all, like, people want to hear from Chills. Fuck Lex. This is Chill Show. They want to know you like getting your nipples sucked. Do you like the nipples?
That's my spot. Like, you hit that spot right, it's game over.
You hit
that spot. I'm trying to tell you. We about to do a dating
that's
show for your motherfucking
that's
ass.
My go-to.
Yeah. I got breast implants.
Dr. Miami, nigga, come here.
That shit is like, I don't know. Just go to my dick and keep it moving. I don't know. I don't need all that nipple shit, my nigga. Like, that shit just like.
The neck nipple, bro?
That shit does nothing for me,
different
yo.
Shows, different shows. Right. I like
licking on necks and like my tongue moves really fast. Me,
I'll be like, yo, just go to my stomach, because I know for my stomach is going to go right a little bit lower. Like, but as far as the nipple and the neck, I said, like, yo, yeah, don't do it. I don't think I have a spot. That's fucked up, too.
Yo, can I keep it a buckle chop?
I don't think I have a spot.
It's no whole
problem. I'm going to keep it a whole buckle chop. I done had a chick. It's going to sound crazy. Casamigos is definitely kicking
it
right
it
now.
It is, right? It's making me
I done had a joint.
The come to Mikasa, son. That's what that shit is called, son.
Come to Mikasa,
yo.
Come to Mikasa.
That's
Casamigos
means.
We was chilling.
Wrap this show. I gotta be going to some Mikasa. Don't fuck with y'all. Don't fuck with y'all. Go ahead.
It's gonna sound crazy. I had a chick. You know, we was chilling and everything was cool. She was like, yo, I'm a massage your feet. I'm cool with the massage and cool. Bro. She's like, let me suck your toes. I was like, I'm like, nah, I don't feel comfortable with that. She's like, nah, let me try it. I'm like, nah, I don't feel comfortable. She's like, let me just try it. It just came out the shower. I was like, make it fast. She threw the toe in her mouth, bro. I've never had that before. Never. Dick said, bing, bing. I said, we gotta go. I'm looking, I'm like,
so do you ask all the girls?
No, absolutely not. Absolutely not. I don't tell nobody. I'm talking too much now. You feel what I'm saying?
I'm sorry.
This is never something I'm asking in the bedroom, but okay. it was presented. And I was like, all right, fuck it. If you want to do it, go ahead, you do it.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't know that was going to have the effect on me the way it did. So I was like, oh, this is a new spot. I'm not
gonna come. You just told everybody. So all the girls in the comments is about to be like, Buff Daddy like his toes.
I don't like my toes suck, but if you
do. If, clearly you do.
Whitney, what I was. But it was different. It was a different spot. So it activated something different for me. And I was just like, okay, cool. But it's not something I tell everybody. You know what I'm saying? So it's
you
just like.
You ever sucked a toe before?
No.
Whitney, you ever sucked a toe before?
I had men suck my toes, but I had men suck my toes.
Did you do that?
No, I didn't suck my own motherfucking toes. Like, I tried to lick my own vagina, but you know,
it didn't work like that.
All right, on to the next one.
All right, next subject.
Okay, next.
You ever looked the ass before?
Oh, yes.
You ever looked the ass before?
Male and female.
You ever looked the ass before?
A woman's ass?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Nigga.
Yes, sir.
What the fuck you talking about right now, Chills? We not saying it that way, Chills. No. This ain't that type of show. Yes. Give me another one.
Oh, my God.
Thank you. All right. This motherfucker here, man. All right.
No Joe Button.
But sometimes, say for men, when they go down on females, like, everything's so close. Like, you.
Like, if you're doing a 69, like, if they're on top of you and they got your ass and they face, like, it might
please, even if you do that, people still do that. I like doing that. But even if you're doing 69, say if the woman's on top and the guy's under and you're sucking his penis, whatever, your nose is in his fucking asshole.
It's booty. It's close. It's very close. And you suck on the nuts.
And then you gotta suck on the balls.
I know, but I say, I don't mean just a goose. I mean an actual ass. I mean, actual asshole.
I've done that before.
Not just a goose.
And then the nigga fucking went crazy. But the goose part, I love that part.
You ever got your ass licked before?
Going crazy.
You ever got your ass licked before, too? Nigga, it's a fucking grown man. Nigga, you ever got your ass licked before, nigga?
What's her name? Yeah, your name.
Casamigos ain't gonna save you now.
Your cup is empty.
I just finished. That's why.
This is sucks as an alcohol, baby. You gotta speak up, baby.
Nah,
there's no pleading a fifth on this show. There's no pleading a fifth.
You's a lying motherfucker, kid.
Lying,
bro. You's a lying motherfucker, kid.
Bro,
you ain't got to lie, Fred.
I ain't lying.
Like, the problem be like, niggas would ask you, like, yo, did you have your legs up like you were getting your diaper changed and shit? Like, niggas, if that is.
Hey, nigga, was you at the fucking guy in the car?
Or you taking or you know how the mom holds her leg of the baby up and then you in the booty? That's crazy.
Oh, shit. Yo, this show is crazy.
And what did it say?
It was that goose for the win. Yo, what you talking about, Willis? What you talking about?
Gucci!
My nigga Gooch! My nigga Gooch for the win!
I'm super excited about me. I got you
back. Nah, no more breaks. No more break. We're going to straight end the show right now. No more breaks. No more commercial breaks.
You better hold it.
We're going, yeah. Yo, listen.
We have one more. How do you, well, we did the threesomes. We did whatever. We touched on oral, did we?
No.
No, we didn't.
I love, I touched on how much I love getting oral. I did touch on that.
All right, how about this one? I'm about to help all y'all out that's watching. How do you give head?
Great.
What do you mean?
I suck the clit. I lick the clit.
Why are you about to stand up? To me, that's my favorite. That's why I don't like getting it. So I like to give it. I feel like it's a prerequisite.
The thing is that you have to, that's not what I'm asking you.
What?
That's not what I'm asking you.
You want to demonstrate?
How do you get
head? We about to end the show fucking right, mother. We about to end the show motherfucking right, okay?
We'll end it right.
It depends on what they like. I don't like these
hands. How do you give head?
I don't like these hands.
Oh, you got the Bluetooth.
The Bluetooth.
No hands, nigga. No hands.
But if they like hands, then I like hands. And I be making this like extra noise that niggas be going crazy about.
What type of noise you making?
I can't even do it. I have to.
Do it.
Stop.
Do it. Somebody give her a finger or something. Give me your finger. Give me your finger, goddamn it.
Yes.
Hold on. We got some hand sanitizer. We got some hand sanitizer.
We got some hand sanitizer.
Some finger.
I cannot do it.
Jill Scott, that motherfucker.
I'm not Jill Scott shit.
Jill Scott, that motherfucker. Let's go, Whitney. The fans want to see you suck some dick, Whitney.
I'm not sucking dick, but I love sucking dick, though. That's my favorite.
You are a winner.
Say that.
I'm not a big fan of giving head, but I do it. I'm a massage the balls, lick the balls.
Talk into that mic. 1, 2, 1, 2.
Bars.
Spit some bars.
I do it, and I'm pretty fucking good at it. But the thing is that I like the.
You don't got a main 16?
I do.
You don't got a main 16? Sometimes 32?
A main 16. I got it.
Sometimes 32.
Hold on. Do you catch it? Or how does that work? Like, if it's too good.
Spit a swallow.
I'm a swallower.
Spit a swallow.
Oh, no kids left behind.
That's my favorite.
No kids left behind. No kids left behind.
We got winners here.
Listen. We have two great babysitters right here, okay? Two great babysitters. All right. We appreciate that, okay? We love the kids. We love the kids on sex, love, and alcohol.
Yes.
We love the kids.
We love you for loving the kids.
I love it. That's my favorite. Like I said, it's a fucking prerequisite before the sex. It has to happen.
Okay. Is that with anybody you fuck with?
No.
That's a big thing.
If it's somebody who I don't really like.
If anybody's dick just in your mouth?
No.
Okay, Whitney, because that's a big, like that, woo!
If I like the person, then you have to get the whole thing.
What's the whole thing?
Listen, I'm not talking to you right now, Whitney. Chills. I'll talk to you after, bro.
We're gonna chop it, bro.
That's my little big bro right there, y'all. That's my little big bro.
Little big bro.
Now we switching over. How you give head?
I'm not gonna say cyber.
Are you one of the people that get comfortable and lay on your stomach and just?
That's how he just said sniper mode.
That's how he came from that shit. All that friction. He was like, "Dance from that motherfucker."
In the back and just like.
And go to work. I like this. Honestly, I'm a pleaser, so I take my time with.
Or do you be? Are you the lazy one and go on your knees on the edge of the bed and just have a like? You know.
I'm trying to.
You gotta get comfortable.
I'm trying to make
you gonna be down there for a while.
I'm trying to make you talk to God. This is a life changing experience.
I'm not stopping until you're shaking or throwing Michael J. Fox shit.
I'm trying to fuck you. By the time I'm done, you're going to need an accessory to get out of my crib.
That's
fucking serious.
You spit a swallow.
Yo, this nigga's funny right here, yo.
You spit a when if you doing what you're doing, a girl squirting, you squitting and swallowing.
Spin that shit out. The fuck?
All right.
What the fuck? That's the thing. Let him spit it out.
I'm spit it out and go right back to work.
I got a whole damn.
I'm not, Dutch, you holding it, Dutch? She's scoring wild, crazy in your mouth. What you doing with that? Why does question came to Dutch? Because, you know, I am bomb McClyde. What's the next subject? What the fuck, bro? How you go down? I already told, I'm sucking, I'm licking, I'm doing everything to that clit. Like, and a lot of them try to hold on, niggas. Why niggas don't know how to eat pussy or fuck, right? You have to take care of the fucking clit. Where the camera at? Take care of the clit. Take care of the fucking clit. It's all about
first
the clit work.
Suck
the clit. Lick the clit. Do everything to the get underneath the clit. Fucking play with the clit. Caress the clit. Massage the clit. Spread the clit. Fuck with the clit. It's all clitoral fucking work. The clit is where they, that's their spot. Like, play with the clit. Play with the fucking clit, fellas. And then we go, thing I do. No! Clit work, motherfucker. Stop playing. Okay. Back to the regular schedule program.
You spitting and swallowing.
Who, me? Did we back to that question?
You didn't answer it. What do you mean back to that question?
Back to that
answer
question?
I don't care.
Why you
fucking
with me?
Yo, what the fuck, chill, Mike, anyway.
I don't like
it. You don't give a fuck, she don't like it.
But my thing is this too, side note. Like, I really want to, like, eat poom poom. And I really want to eat it so bad because I think that I'm going to eat it as good as I fuck it.
Let me ask y'all a question. If y'all don't, because, like, enough for nothing, it takes me a little minute to come from head. I ain't going to say a minute, but y'all gonna go to work. You gonna work for that shit. You gonna work to get that nut out. Did that give y'all extra motivation when a nigga doesn't come as fast when giving head? Did that make y'all go harder? Or
Sometimes it depends on the noise, if they leg is shaking, all that shit. I be feeding them for that. And if they tell me like, oh, no hands, no hands. They want hands, hands. I'm gonna give it to you how you want it.
You like the nigga to grab your head?
Can I say something? Yo, that's my fucking favorite. When they holding it down, and I can't even. No, he not gonna pull the whistle.
What if he tried to?
Then he pull it off. We just set it on braids at that point. It's a Cleo. It's a Cleo at that point.
You got the meat milk on there. I'm gonna put the wig back on.
It's the Cleo.
Well, let me say one thing. This is for men.
You got some fans out here, bro.
Listen, one thing before y'all. Listen. Male and female, do not get offended if somebody comes to your house or apartment or say hotel and they go to the bathroom first. First of all, you cannot go down on somebody with a fucking dirty ass mouth. Brush your fucking teeth. Okay? There is actually a real thing as bacterial vaginitis. You can actually give a female a bacteria by going down with a dirty ass fucking mouth. Brush your fucking teeth. Carry your fucking toothbrush.
And then with women.
It's a brush your fucking teeth. You can transfer bacteria from your mouth.
Watch the
fucking crack.
What is that?
What the hell is that?
A mint? Okay, cool. Let me get one.
She's
thank
some
you.
Dick in
thank you. I thought I needed
you some fucking love, Whitney.
I'm gonna go to work after this.
Whitney, here we go. Listen, 9 to 5,
that's
nigga.
That's my fucking favorite.
Clock in, all right? Listen, there's no sex, love, and alcohol.
Yes, no wet wipes. Oh, by the way, no wet. Listen,
mouthwash don't clear everything, but toothpaste and mouth, yo, dead ass, like, all jokes aside, like, because, like, you know, a lot of us do put their mouths on other people.
Wash your dicks.
Guys, don't throw away, like, oh, why Shorty was going to the bathroom? You better be glad she has to go to the motherfucking bathroom. Oh, do you have a bathroom? Where's the bathroom at? Don't fucking, you just, listen.
Yo, let me tell you something.
And sometimes I ask myself up in the bathroom, too. I'll be like, bitch, you got this, yo. That's how I be.
If someone wants to be clean for you, take that as a compliment.
Because I hear a lot of guys, yo, every time you gotta go to the bathroom, nigga, you be glad she goes to the fucking bathroom. Worry about the ones that don't want to go to the bathroom before y'all fucking start doing something.
You understand? But you know what I mean?
That bacteria shit is crazy.
Y'all just nasty.
Go get ready.
Y'all just nasty. Wash your asses.
God is washing.
I'm
smelling.
So, listen, I want to thank you guys. This is a fucking dope ass show. Thank you guys for tuning in. Thank you, Whitney.
Thank you, Chills.
Appreciate y'all for having me on this
show.
Chills.
This is what we're going to do.
He about to get all of the bullshit.
We're about to set shows. Listen, ladies. I'm about to set Chill's OnlyFans page up right after the show, right?
I already got OnlyFans.
You look like you got a fucking OnlyFans.
How do I look like that, though?
Because you do. You look
Yo,
like you
this
do.
This ain't like just working out. This right. In the gym. Ooh, no, we're going to do something different. We're just going to do something that's just corny. Fucking just, look at me. No, we're going to do something
different. Let me brag on him real quick. Yo, if you guys are not, what is, how you say your page? His page is Charm and Fitness, but he does a lot of, like, I call him the fake Derek Jenks or whatever, you know, y'all know what I'm saying. The fake Derek Jenks, son, because
he does a lot of motivation for women. Don't call him the fake Derek Jenks, because I will spaz on this nigga right now for calling him that, don't do that, put that shit on this man.
Check out his page.
Listen, this is Chills. This ain't no fat
Devastation. Even though
this is Chills.
Not that guy.
I can't. Give me a second. Even though he has, his thing is trans.
Kevin Samuels ass
fitness,
nigga.
He has other things too. Make sure you guys follow Whitney. I am Whitney Felice.
My name is Whitney Felice.
My on Instagram.
Name is. Her name is.
Don't
fellas,
forget.
Fellas, follow her.
Here we go.
Follow her, fellas.
Don't put them niggas in. Okay, and of course, you know, my co-host right here, HD_Dutch, you know, and also his, he has a massage, yo.
Yo, listen,
ladies,
listen.
If you want that rubbed up.
No, I do regular, real, professional massages. I'm right there. There's no bullshit, no. Come check me out. Listen. Graceful Touch Massages on Instagram, okay? Come check me out. Very professional. I got 15% discount for new-time clients. Like, this shit is real. We do different thing. We have someone that does. I have a lady, that young lady in there that does facials. She does organic hair removal. That's called sugaring. And she does teeth whitening. So we do a whole package. I got a whole package. Like, holla at me. It's very professional, very therapeutic. We do deep tissue. We do Swedish. I do sports, hot stones. I got hot towel warmers.
He do everything.
Yes, it's real. Instead of going to Ling Ling and them, holler at me.
And
right?
Of course, you know, it's me,
real.
Your girl Chrissy in the building. You guys can follow me on my personal page at li_Chris. No, what the fuck is my name? L-I.
Yeah, you very good.
I told you I have L-I an effect on women Chrissy. Sometimes.
That's not it.
Ew.
Okay. And also, don't forget to follow Sex, Love, and Alcohol on Instagram as well, you know, and
we sexy.
Don't forget, you know, follow Jamaican, shout out to our sponsors, please. Listen, our sponsors, Jamaican Paradise Restaurant is located in Long Island. It's in Copeg. The holidays are coming. If you don't, it's a busy time of year. If you don't feel like cooking or whatever, please hit them up. They do full catering, whether you want entrees, little dishes here and there, or your full meal, turkeys, whatever you need. They do full catering. You know, hit up their Instagram page or email them for orders if you want. Also, for your makeup needs, shout out to Hot Commodity Cosmetics and Lash Studio.
I'm wearing it right now.
Yo, not for nothing. That food is mad good, too. That shit is good as fuck.
Yeah,
not the food joint that's just.
Yeah.
That shit is amazing.
Shit is mad fucking good.
That shit is delicious.
But keep on going, but go ahead.
Yes, but you know, I'm a smoker.
I smoke a lot of marijuana, people. When I say food is good, go ahead.
I can't.
She's talking about the makeup, though.
I don't wear makeup. I got to talk about the food.
The makeup, I'm wearing it. Go ahead.
Thank you. But also, you know, for your makeup needs, they have a website, www.hotcommoditycosmetics.com. And the Instagram is hotcommodity_cosmetics. And it's HAUTE, not HOT.
I'm listening.
And I want to give you guys a little preview of next week's show. Every show, you know, the show is called Sex, Love, and Alcohol. We do talk. We're not relationship therapists. So we don't talk about the good shit in love. We don't try to tell you how to get a man, get a woman, or whatever. We talk about problems and stuff and that might go on in relationships. So, of course, next week's show will be more relationship-based. And next week's show will be about, like, trauma, like mental, emotional, physical trauma that people may face prior to relationship and getting into it, whether you was raped, whether you were physically abused or whatever, and you bring that into your relationship and how it might affect your relationship. And also the other topic for next week also will be supporting your spouse or your partner or whoever you might be dealing with, whether or not you agree with their business venture, their anything that they like, their dreams, their ventures, or they business, whatever they want to do. Like sometimes you might not agree with what they're doing, or say it might not be beneficial for your relationship, or might not be bringing money into your relationship, or even helping your growth, and you're just like totally against it. But this is what they love. Will you support them still, or will you just be like, nah, you gotta get rid of this? Like whatever, even though it's something that they are passionate about and that they love. You know. So next week's show will be about that, and we will have Ray Large in the building next week, and also. I'm going to say her name, D. Graves. She will be in the building next week as well. So we have some really dope guests that actually have real life experiences that they've been through this that can actually help you guys. And we will actually try to help you cope with the situation and tell you how to work it out. So, you know, tune in next week. So it won't be like a sex show next week. It'll be like more of a relationship love show. So if you're interested, make sure you tune in. But thank you guys. Yo, Sex, Love, and Alcohol is on each and every Friday at 9 p.m. We're live, and even if you missed the show, you can go back and replay it. We're on iHeartRadio, Pandora, Twitch, Anchor, Facebook.
Everything.
Not Facebook. We're on everything. Every single podcast, iTunes. We're on Google Play. Make sure you guys download the app. You can also replay the show, forward it to your friends, tell a friend to tell a friend, and tune in. You're like, it's a dope show. And if you ever want to be a guest, if you we're open to all guests. So if you ever can relate to any sex questions, love questions, and we will make the topics to if you do come on our show, the topics will be formed around you, something that you can actually tune into and relate to. So you know what I mean? Like, I'm welcome to everything. You can DM us, hit us on Instagram or email us or whatever, and we'll put you on the show. So thank you guys again, and thank you our guest, Whitney. Thank you, Chills.
Thanks for all the viewers.
Me and Dutch appreciate you guys. Thank you for all the viewers. The comments was lit. All right, y'all was lit in these comments today.
Thanks to everybody.
You know what I mean? Thank you for the callers. You know, thank you for interacting with us, and we appreciate you guys, yo. And, you know, tune in with us again next Friday, 9 p.m. We at the same place, same time, baby.
We'll be back.
Sex, Love, and Alcohol, and thank you guys.
That was fun. Can I use the bathroom now? I got
it. No, you're still on punishment.
Come on, man.
Go daddy. Go.